Hello. I want to talk to you today about a somewhat unusual subject. And the reason is that the lay media in recent weeks and months suddenly found special interest in the question whether food intake affects fertility. And all kinds of claims have been made in newspapers, in television programs, even in medical journals. Yes, even in medical journals, we were told that eating more fast food delays the time to pregnancy. On the other hand, eating more fruit makes pregnancy more likely. Unfortunately, most of these claims are what in other spheres of life would be called fake news. Very little data to support them. If there are data, they are usually poorly assessed, poorly interpreted, and therefore really do not allow for any significant conclusions. Of course, it is better to eat healthy. Of course, it is better to work out and to live a healthy life. Of course, it's bad to smoke. Of course, it's even worse to use drugs. All of that is clear. We have known for decades that excessive weight is bad for IVF. We don't know exactly why, but just statistically speaking, obese women have lower pregnancy rates than non-obese women. We have known that. But the general concept that we should deprive ourselves in order to conceive, we feel is not only incorrect, but actually can be damaging. And with this onslaught of recent reports, and therefore with the increasing questions that we face from our patients, we felt it was time to address this point. Here is one good example that I think really best answers the question of importance of food. I'm sure you have heard recently that drinking coffee is bad. I'm sure you have also heard that consuming alcohol, or even a glass of wine, is bad for getting pregnant. Now think about that. Have you been to Spain? Have you been to Italy? How many times a day is it ingrained in the local culture to have a glass of wine? Or if you go to South America or again to the Mediterranean area in Europe, to have an espresso here and there. Have you ever heard that the populations around the Mediterranean have lower fertility than patients who don't drink that much coffee? Like, for example, Russians who like tea. I have not, nor is there data. And do you really think that those patients who in their culture have wine with lunch and dinner on a routine fashion, have you ever heard that in those countries patients have a harder time getting pregnant? Don't you think that we would know that by now after they have been drinking wine for hundreds, thousands of years? So, a word of caution. Don't believe everything you read, not even in medical journals. Live a healthy life, but enjoy your life. We tell our patients who are trying to get pregnant that as long as there is not a medical reason to do something, the best thing you can do is to live your normal life while you shoulder that additional burden of having to go through fertility treatment. That is stressful enough. Having on top of that, to start a diet, restrict yourself from things that you love, that you do otherwise in a routine fashion, will only raise your stress level, will do nothing to help you conceive. So live healthy, enjoy your life, and do what your infertility specialists ask you, but mostly in a medical sense. Don't listen too closely about dietary advices. Bye-bye.